Today I'm going to introduce oxidation reduction reactions, or better known as redox. And redox reactions are where electrons move or transfer from one element to another. And these are very common reactions. Rusting is redox. Your body is redoxing right now. So is mine. But we'll take a look at it. We're going to look at some metals and how they react. I have some magnesium metal here. Little chunks of magnesium metal. I'm not going to put a whole lot in there. And to it, I'm going to add hydrochloric acid. This is known as muriatic acid in a hardware store. This is 6 molar. And when I add this, you're going to see fizzing, bubbles, steam is getting very hot. We definitely have a reaction going on. So what's the reaction? The reaction is magnesium solid is giving its electrons to the HCl to make magnesium ion and hydrogen gas. Okay, so the magnesium here is going to give up 2 electrons, and each hydrogen is going to gain 1 electron. But we have 2 hydrogens, so the electrons lost and transferred to the gain is the same. That's always the case. And many metals will do that. You can see we no longer have any solid in this flask. Why? Magnesium chloride is a soluble salt. Another common material is zinc. If you've ever heard of a galvanized pipe or a galvanized nail, that means it's coated with zinc. And again, we can put a little bit of zinc in this flask. And we can add hydrochloric acid to it. And again, you can see bubbling. Not quite as vigorous as the magnesium, but definitely bubbling for sure. And it's producing hydrogen gas as well, and it's getting warm. And basically the same reaction is happening. Okay, instead of the magnesium though, I've got zinc here. So zinc is, and the zinc will slowly dissolve. It's going to take longer because the reaction is not as fast. All right, so many metals react with acid. In fact, only some metals are somewhat acid resistant. They then tend to be very expensive, like gold or platinum. They are resistant to normal acid attack. Last but not least, though, we can actually have other reactions occur that are redox. Again, I am going to take some zinc solid. And in this case, I'm going to add copper sulfate. Now, copper sulfate is very blue. And in copper sulfate, we have the copper 2 plus ion, which causes the blue color. Okay? So that's always a good identification. If it's really blue like this and it has copper in it, it probably is a copper 2 plus ion. So now I'm going to add the copper to this zinc and swirl, and a little more zinc. And you may see, I'll bring it a little closer to the camera, what we'll see is happening here is we can see that the solution is almost colorless. The blue copper solution has gone away. And if you look closely, that zinc is no longer shiny silver, but it's kind of got a little brown on it. See that? Look at that liquid. Almost no blue. That tells us the copper ion is no longer there. And that brownish coating on the zinc that's no longer silvery is actually copper solid. So what's happened is two electrons have moved from the zinc to the copper. Now in all these reactions, the atoms or ions actually hit. They have to touch. And when they touch, electrons move from one to the other. Why does this happen? This is nature. It's energetically favorable. It's just like a ball rolling down a hill. Okay? The electron, quote unquote, sees a different place to go. It's lower in energy, so it goes there. So these are three examples of oxidation-reduction reactions.